So it blends.
It blends. This is a monocrystalline type of solar panel. It was new when I bought it. And it was giving out more than 41 volts and maybe 10 amps. I didn't measure the amps, but I don't know whether it's meant to measure the amps. It's 10 amps because of what I was able to use it to do. But now it has cracked. I don't know why it has cracked. So it doesn't deliver 41, doesn't even deliver to 30 volts again. So it is cracked and it is dirty. The dirty is sitting in and blocking sunlight from getting in. So what we are going to do now is to see how we can apply, even though it's not delivering much again. We want to see how we can apply what we believe to do some work. Now I'm cleaning out the dust to improve the output. That's what it will do. It will improve the output. It's really great to do. Down now. So this is the output terminal of that solar panel. Let's see what it is giving out here. I put my multimeter on DC 200. This is the positive and this is the negative. Positive to positive. And negative to negative. What did it give us? It gives us 34. As today is bright, so we have 34 here today. So I'm going to connect it to this solar charger and see if I can use it to keep this 24 volt battery charged. So this solar charger is the smart charge controller. Is going to go to negative. Meanwhile, you're supposed to connect your battery to the charge controller first before you connect the solar panel. So let us do that. Positive terminal battery. So the positive output of the charge controller. Negative to negative output of the charge controller. The charge controller at this point in time. Show us the voltage of the battery, which is, don't know, it's upside down here, it's 27.8 volts, in a good state of charge. You know, I'm going to connect the solar panel, keep it charged, while we try to use it. Driving DC motor to the battery. On the switch. Switch is on. Alright.
the voltage can still be used, 28.8.
Now let's see the voltage of this of these four batteries. The voltage of these four batteries is 51 volts. Now the voltage that is coming out from the generator is what? What does it give us? 57.6 volts, which is good to charge 4 volt battery. So I'm connecting it to the 4 volt battery now. It's connected. The battery is charging 52.8 volts, 52.9. So it's charging. So the next step now will be for us to go and connect this battery to load and see if that cracked solar panel is going to do something. No, 53 volts now, 3.1 is charging. So this is how to go about. If you have a solar panel that you think is useless, you see, permanent magnet alternator is able to give you more. So now it's giving us more. 3.2 is still charging. So we are going to connect load to this. Okay.
Gains in the voltage loss.
The battery is on 24.9 volts. Although it's charging from solar panel. Then this one that is being charged. What is the charge state? Let's check. The charge state is uh, 54.4. It was 51 when we started. Now it is 54.4. Now we have to add load and see. I have one DC blender that I can add. Let me go and carry it. Yeah. This is a DC blender. It's a DC blender, 48 volts. It's due to work with 48 volts. What's the voltage there? Okay. It's 54.4 volts. So the DC blender is running. 52.2. The DC blender is running. Can you see it is running? It's running. So now let's put some fruits to blend. It blends.